I'm Jeff Lane. I'm the son, the eldest son of Bruce Langdon Lane. My desire right now is to share a little bit about my dad and some of the journey that we got to travel together with. Coming to you from Yorba Linda, California, which is where our family spent much of its time, and much of the time spent from my childhood comes from Yorba Linda, California. It's great. We're in the upstairs room of our home in Yorba Linda. I've got my wife, Pam, here. I've got three grandchildren with me as well, Ada, Cade, and Bryn. And they're going to share a little bit later of something that they want to share with their great-grandfather. So as we try to do this, trying to keep it authentic and real, sometimes that's difficult, but my heart's desire is just to share the love that I've had for a relationship with my dad. Bruce Langdon Lane was born October 29th, 1935. He died July 2nd, 2022. Obviously, the stories that come to my mind and the things that I think about my dad are integral in the upbringing of a young boy. One of the things that I thought about and that my dad and I talked about was what we can do from one another and learning what to do and what not to do from everyone and every situation. Because every situation that we had wasn't joyful. There were things that were difficult that we traversed through as well. But I'm grateful for all of it. I'm grateful for the whole journey. You know, as a young boy, my dad was my God and my hero. He was the man that was playing softball and hitting the ball 5 miles, it seemed to me, as a young boy. And watching him play and do what he did and interact with his friends was something that was modeled for me. I remember being stuck in a tree one time up in the mountains, and I was so scared I couldn't move. And my dad came and climbed that tree and brought me back down to safety. It's a great memory. It's a great memory. So he was my God and my hero. I have a few stories that I'd like to share. Some of the things that I have kept over the years are things that are reminders of these stories. I have one back behind me. It's a bowling pin. So this bowling pin I have saved since I was about 9 years old or 8. My dad was in a bowling league with my mom, and they would leave one of the weeknights, let's just say Friday night, they'd go bowling. Well, one night my dad came home with a bowling pin, and I said, "Dad, how did you get the bowling pin?" "Well, son, I threw the ball down there, and I knocked all those pins down, and I knocked them all down so hard that this bowling pin came back up with the ball. It came up through the ball return." And I've kept that once again as a memory of my dad and the journey that we got to travel together. It's been sometimes difficult, but it's been wonderful. So these are treasured memories. Another memory that we have when I was a little bit older is this pipe. So this pipe on it is a reminder of the time we played fast pitch softball together. Fast pitch softball was an integral part of my dad's life. He got to play a number of years. He was a wonderful pitcher in the league down when he worked at the Los Angeles Times, and he played with some incredible friends that he had, and I got to see that modeled. And as I grew older, I thought how fun it would be to get to play softball as well. So we did that, and my dad coached our first team in 1979. We were called the Langdons, and we got this pipe because my dad smoked a pipe, and we got it big because my dad was a big hero to me. We put all the guys' names. So when I look at this, I just think of those stories of Randy and Sue and Neil and everybody being on that team. Chris Loftus, Jeff Loftus, my brother-in-law Scott. Oh my goodness, we went on to play some wonderful seasons in that. Well, it's been sometimes difficult, obviously, as we worked together as well. And my dad gave me the blessing of learning my craft to be a printer. And I'm very grateful for that. I also want to thank so many of you who supported my dad over the years and supported myself. I think about Brenda And I want to thank Brenda. She loved my dad with an unconditional love and took care of him at a high level. So thank you very much, Brenda, for doing that. Once again, kind of the three sections of my dad's life, it seems like, when he was young and married to my mother, and he has a set of friends from that time period in his life. And then he went on and was the president of the Shih Tzu of America Club, which was an interesting time of life when he had a wonderful experience going to New York and Japan and showing these dogs around the world, you know. And then his time with Brenda and all those wonderful people when he moved to Oklahoma. So we want to thank all of you for that. And I do want to thank all of you for the support and love you've poured out as recently that my dad died. You know, I have friends, Chris Loftus sent some great pictures of us water skiing. You know, my dad, when I was about 15, got a boat and we got to learn how to water ski. And that became another wonderful time in our lives to get to do that. Right before he died, we had taken a trip to a lake called Clear Lake. We hadn't been there in 42 years. And before my dad passed away, I got to share with him that his grandchildren learned to water ski. Ada got up on skis. Cade got up on skis for the very first time at Clear Lake. And I got to ski on a seat ski that we had bought 42 years ago, that my dad had bought 42 years ago, that gave us a lot of joy. And I got to ski on that kind of as a fun memory of those times. Well, as I've told you, I've got Ada and Cade and Bryn and my wonderful wife Pam is here as we share. And Ada and Bryn wanted to put together a little dance routine for Pop G-Rock for them. So I want to come over. Ada and Bryn, could you please come over here? All right. And can you say hello?
Hello.
Hi. So they're going to do a little dance routine now. As a little something that they're going to share for G-Rock. Would you like to say something to G-Rock and Brenda? So why don't you look over at Maggie?
I would like to say, we're sorry that
G-Rock
passed away.
Look up at the camera.
And we hope that you guys
find comfort, right?
Find comfort, and we hope you have a wonderful day tonight. And
you want to say that you want to tell Brenda that you love her?
I love her.
And you love G-Rock?
I love you, G-Rock.
All right. Thank you very much. Thanks, girls. Now, there's a great-grandson, Cade Langdon Lane. He's right here. Come back, Cade. And can you say hello?
Hello.
Tell us your name. Tell us your full name.
I'm Cade Langdon Lane.
That's right. This is G-Rock's great-grandson.
These are my sisters.
Yes. Cade, what did you get to do this year as...
Donut shop.
We went to the donut shop today, but you got to play baseball this year, didn't you?
Yeah.
You played on the Yankees this year, right?
Yeah.
And we played in what league? We played in your Belinda Little League. It was a wonderful thing, and I'd like to share that Cade is the fourth generation to get to play in West your Belinda Little League.
Can I do a show?
You want to do a show? You want to do the Batman dance?
Oh, yeah, the Batman.
All right, Cade's going to do a little Batman dance. So we want to thank you for watching this video and taking the time. Once again, I wish I could be everywhere in person, but just wanted to share a snippet of what we and the love that I have for my dad and all of you that support him over the years. One of the other things that we shared was music. We shared music together. And I've had the wonderful opportunity of singing hymns with my dad. But a fond memory is of Calvary Church when my dad would sing. He was in the choir. It's just a wonderful memory of those times. One of the songs that we'd like to kind of close with right now is a song and a hymn called Just a Closer Walk with Thee.
Just a closer walk with Thee, granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, oh so close, let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
Come on now.
I am weak, but Thou art strong. Jesus keeps me from all wrong. I'll be satisfied as I walk. Dear Lord, walk with Thee.
Come
on. Just a closer walk with Thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, oh so close, let it be. Dear Lord, let it be. World of toil and snares. If I falter, Lord, who cares? Who with me my burden shares, none but Thee, dear Lord, none but Thee.
Come on, everybody!
Just a closer walk with Thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, oh so close, let it be.
Let it be.
Dear Lord, let it be. Listen, when my feeble life is o'er, time for me will be no more. Guide me gently, safely yours, to Thy kingdom shore, to Thy shore.
Come on, everybody, come on.
Just a closer walk with Thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, oh so close, let it be. Dear Lord, let it be.
Come on, just a closer.
Woo!
Just a closer walk with Thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, oh so close, let it be.
Let it be.
Dear Lord, let it be. Let it be. Dear Lord, let it be. Let it be. Dear Lord, let it be.
Well, that was a rousing, just a closer walk with Thee. Oh, We love all of you. Thank you for letting me share a little bit from my heart. Thank you for all of you. Dad, I love you. And like Ada said at the beginning, she said, well, Pop-Pop, why do we need to film this? If G-Rock's up in heaven, he can see it. Yeah, he can. But we wanted to share this with everyone still here at Earth. And of course, our heart's desire is that all would come to the full knowledge of Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, like my dad did. He surrendered his life to Christ many years ago. And we got to talk about that as he got closer to the end of his life here on earth. And then he passed away into eternity, into heaven, in the presence of God. We love all of you. Thank you once again for letting us share from this video. And we want to say goodbye and God bless. You guys want to say goodbye and God bless to D-Rock? And here's Cade coming in with a little trophy. You want to hold that trophy up, Cade? Here, step back a little bit so I can see you. Yeah, we have trophies and we have some of these things like the bowling pin and the pipe and many different things.
Yes!
As reminders of the journey that we got to travel together. It's just like what God told us and what he told the Israelites to post it over your door frames. Tie it around your neck so you don't forget these stories. These are just earthly stories with earthly relationships. And they're wonderful. Of course, they pale in comparison to our relationship with Jesus Christ. But thank you to each and every one of you. Love you all. I love you, Dad. Thanks for the journey. God bless. Everybody say goodbye.
Bye.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this, I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself,